We have a big map, and it could be the last. To the bottom left, the Terran player, the last man standing for FX Open.
FXOSC
will not likely be happy that they are cross-spawns.
Yeah.
His opponent, the Protoss player, is starting to the top right of the map, taking down Leenok, defeating Gumiho. Now up against his third opponent, it is
StarTail, Avenge.
Avenge just playing his aggressive style against Gumiho last game. Really, really fast. 10 gate into Stalker, Mothership Core Aggression, got into the main base, recalled out. Did some damage, got all the scout information, then lingered, made sure the command center couldn't be taken, and hit a nice timing. So, just very crisp play, and it's what you expect to see from Avenge.
Yep.
I really want to see what he's going to do in this game. I could definitely see him to play really greedy on a map like this and just trying to play the opposite style from what he has shown against Gumiho, trying to also mind game his opponent a little bit. And as you already said, there's not a lot of pressure for Avenge. He already did what was expected, he did a lot more, and he knows that there are strong players to back him up if he loses this match.
It looks like both players are going to go Town Hall first, if you will. CC first and a Nexus first. And this is just, with cross spawns, we're leading up so far at the beginning of this game, looking like it's going to be a longer one, a very long macro game, which could be epic. A lot of Terrans struggling in the late game. Some Terrans not, like Byun, for example, showing that even when it comes to late game, his opponent has better upgrades than him, he can just keep a better army and fight with it, good micro.
Nexus first now against Command Center first. There we go. So we have definitely a bit of time on our hands, a bit of more of a late game scenario compared to the matches that we've seen before. A lot of banter going on to tie between the teams. It was a little bit disappointing to see Bomber versus Leenok end this fast.
Yeah.
But Avenge and his style certainly makes up for that.
Let's see a little bit more information here about FX Open. Mostly contributing by Zerg. A lot of that, of course, Leenok.
Yeah, for FX Open, the most successful player that they have so far is still Hurricane, who also got an all-kill. It's actually the only team, if I'm not mistaken, that has two all-killers so far this season, Hurricane and SC. SC, of course, has a perfect record here, with only playing in the all-kill match, taking a 4-0, and now he finds himself up against StarTail, so I guess the record at some point is going to fall. It would be really a little bit of a miracle if he is able to take down three opponents right now.
But
StarTail has to be careful, they can't get complacent here. Life in this season has not been showing the perfect matches and the really strong performance that everyone expected. Still playing strong and like getting good results, but not as dominating as people thought he would.
Yeah, you know, Life's skill set is you know, not... I don't want to say it's not for GSTL, but he really shines in a best of series more so than a best of one. You know, he's not invincible when it comes to best of ones, so... He can really watch the series and develop his playstyle against his opponent really, really well. Oh, will he get in the main? He already knows it's CC first, so he can just run away.
Exactly, and that's exactly what he does. He, saves the probe. Avenge is now actually 5-2 in the GSTL. A really good record for him. You know, I just love this. That we talked about it a little bit in a few of the last matches and also when the Koei games were going on, but I really love how there are a lot of teams out there who are always able to just support the newer players. And Avenge is, of course, not... If you look at it time-wise, he's not really new. He was already playing back then at Zenex. But he just... He is like... He bloomed when he was in StarTail. They lost a lot of Protoss players, and he's now stepping it up so much. He's really a contender these days. Getting a name for himself, throwing his name out there. And it's just awesome to see that. That teams like StarTail are not only focusing on the same heavy hitters, but then bringing in a player like Avenge to complete their lineup, to make them a little bit less predictable.
They're so fostering talent.
Exactly.
You know?
It's just like... They are... I just love that we have players like Avenge just stepping it up.
Yeah, definitely so. Speaking of Avenge, he's going for Oracles here.
Yeah.
We'll definitely try to get some SCV kills since he knows it's a CC first. There'll be late turrets and very few Marines. And beyond that, Revolution ability really, really handy against drop play.
One of the players that FXO would really like to use here is, of course, Seed, but because of the late addition to the roster, he can't play in this team match.
Yep. We discussed that a little bit earlier, but he's joined a little bit too late to be eligible. I think if they make it to the playoffs, he'll be able to play. That Stalker missed the SCV. I think he didn't see it at all, so he's actually potentially going to be scouted here. That's really unfortunate.
Yeah, that would be very annoying. The SCV is already out. We have still a Stalker just... You know, I actually don't think that this is an accident. He's just trying to make sure that there's nothing to spot him.
Yeah, I think he must have seen it, but he wanted to keep his other Stalker there. And
that
he's just gonna...
so awesome for him. I mean, could it be any better? The SCV is trying to get away, trying to perform a bit of a dance here around the Stalker, but Avenge isn't a guy who is easily fooled, so heading into the main base very soon with the Oracle. He could do a lot here.
Yeah, double E-base going down, but a bit late, and plus one air weapons coming out, so this is definitely going to be a unique strategy. He's going into the Void Ray first, so we could just see a timing attack with plus one Void Rays, but before that, here comes the very first Oracle attack. He's losing already two SCVs. He's going to lose a Mule.
Yeah, loses the Mule here as well. The Marines are moving in. The Stalker's at the front. Still doing a little bit of damage. But we have the Void Rays now coming in, and the second one is already being built. This is going to be a very aggressive. Once again, Avenge is just playing on the law here. Another three gateways being added by him.
Yeah, I think he's just going to hit with probably four Void Rays and plus one and just bust down those bunkers.
And this is so unbelievably strong, especially with the prismatic alignment now. You can do so much. You have the Oracle that can always dart into the main base into the mineral line when the Terran player has to defend at the front. And if you don't have your units spread out perfectly, even if you hold it at the front, you suffer so many losses back home in the mineral line. Your SCV count will just drop like a stone, and the Protoss will still be in the lead. So this is a really, really strong attack here.
Focusing most of his Chrono Energy only on the Void Ray production is not Chrono Boosting that plus one attack. And, you know, it's going to line up really nicely once he starts to fly across the map. He wants to make sure he can deny all scouts. He has control over the map. He killed that SCV specifically, so he knows there's no way, never know how, anything is going to see his push coming across right now.
Talking about knowing, you know, one person who doesn't know a thing here is actually the FX Open player. Nice, even delays now the starport, takes down the SCV. No scouting information for SC here. Yeah. Avenge is going to hit him, and he does not know anything that's going on.
This is going to be a smackdown. He's got only the two bunkers.
Well, it's super strong here. And the main base still, the Oracle, just waiting for a chance. Plus one is now done, three Void Rays. He's even hallucinating additional ones.
So
this
smart.
This is great. This tactic is so strategical. Moving into the main base, I'm losing the Oracle, a little bit of a misstep, but he's baiting the Marines even deeper into the base.
Yep. Here comes that Photon Overcharge, or rather I should say Prismatic Alignment on the bunkers.
And bye-bye bunker one and two, the Marauder is down.
Guardian Shield here.
Supply depots don't stand a chance. Hallucination is good. Additional warp-ins. He needs to get those Stalkers into the base,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, 1-1 is about to finish for SC. It's going to help him, but of course the supply block certainly is not.
He forgot his Stalkers.
Yeah, he needs to send those Stalkers over here. I mean, he's still in a great spot, but could be much better. The force fields are decent, blocking most of those Marines out, but the lift is good.
There are more force fields that go. Here come those late medivacs, finally. But do we have enough units for Avenge? The Stalker is still chilling to the right side of the map.
Yeah, the Stalkers on the right side of the map are very wanted here, and the Void Rays start to fall.
The Void Rays are starting to fall, but there's still enough of them, and good micro here by Avenge, immediately pulling the injured Void Ray back, and he just has simply too much.
Yep, that Commander's going to fall. Those Stalkers still forgotten.
He doesn't even need them. He's moving in, taking down Marines and Marauders alike. The medivacs are going down. Another force field at the front, and he just has way too many units. He's already taking a huge supply lead with 108 versus 56.
Yeah, he's just going to walk up. Doesn't care about the concave. There's mostly just SCVs in here. Not even enough anti-air at this point.
Avenge like a boss, taking down Leenok, taking down Gumiho, and winning against the sea, dancing his units.
Avenge is a boss, man. One of the most aggressive Protoss players we've ever seen, and he is doing it well. And
this
that's it.
This guy is on such a roll. It's crazy.
Mana Nexus.
The Mana Nexus and the main base. Oh, wow. SC, it's time to type GG.
Goodbye, perfect record.
Yep.
GG.
This is it. Avenge has delivered.
Such a cool... We saw different sets of strategies, different types of strategies from him in every single game.
Whoever is in his up and down group has to be very, very careful and probably looks at these games with a little bit of worry.
Yeah. Shoya not happy.
Yeah.
And this gives, you know, StarTail a more solid appearance or a more solid ranking in the overall scores.
Yeah, this is not about FXO losing, this is about FXO getting crushed here with a 4-1.
Really going to hurt their indicator.
And by a player that they probably did expect to come out, but they didn't expect him to play this well.
Yeah, Leenok falling early on, really putting a dent in Epic's Open roster, it certainly showed. And then losing Gumiho, the way they lost him. And also Hurricane not really being able to deliver. Those three things, you know, when we're having this best of seven instead of best of nine format, that's just kind of how the cookie crumbles.
Avenged just looks stronger and stronger every time we see him in the booth, and he gets so much more experience, and that helps. That helps a lot. And it also helps him to prepare a bit for his up and down matches, I feel, because nerf issues was what really we saw him in the last games when he lost. And if he can keep it calm and collected in the up and downs, I feel that we might actually see him next season in Codest.
Yeah, up and down matches where sometimes you have to play all three matchups. You play so many different opponents, so it's very similar to the GSTL. In fact, if the up and down matches goes the full way, you might play more opponents in the up and downs than you might even have in the GSTL possible. Yep. So that skill set to be able to do different strategies on different maps against different opponents, being able to do what he just did today, is actually really, it's a very similar skill set to what he needs for the up and downs.
And the thing is, just what we saw today is him playing a very, very aggressive style. But if you remember the games against Flash, he played a very different style. He went into the macro game, he played a very drawn out game on the same map. So he has all these styles that he can mix in depending on what exactly the Terran does, and also try to mind game his opponent. So a very solid performance here by Avenged, taking three opponents down, and that was really incredible. I really loved his play.
Yeah, it was great. I mean, I'm actually looking forward to seeing him in the up and downs. This guy is somebody we've kind of watched grow so much, and he's getting so much more experience, so much more exposure. He's definitely become one of the top players for StarTail. He's definitely in top three for me.
He filled the gap. He definitely filled the gap. They had a bit of a problem with the Protoss lineup after players like Squirtle and Parting left, but now he has stepped it up so much. And of course we have an interview with not only the StarTail coach, but the player of the day, which is of course Avenge.
Just talking to the coach a little bit. I really can't wait to see what Avenge has to say, to be honest.
Yeah.
본인 예선 뚫고 코드 A에서도 경기를 하면서 경험이 쌓이면서 좀 자신감을 많이 찾아가고 있는 것 같아요. 그래서
so at the start of the season, he says Avenge was not really in good shape, but after he went through the preliminaries and played them in the Code A matches, he got into a zone, he got into really good form, and that's what helped him today. Definitely so.
Very,
very much what we have observed, you know, as we've watched this player grow.
오늘 너무 중요한 경기여서 선수들한테도 좀 긴장 좀 했으면 좋겠다고.
So today was a very, very important match, of course, for them.
남준이가 너무 잘해줘가지고 그 승점도 좋게.
He told the players to be confident. Bomber certainly took that to heart. Didn't work too well for him, though.
Not as well as he would have liked. Yeah.
네, 또 강팀들과의 또 상위권 그 팀들과의.
The players were actually a little bit nervous coming to today's match. That's what he just mentioned. He's very thankful to them that they came through for him and the team. But yeah, he said that coming into this game or into this match, they were really nervous before it was such an important match for the league.
And just asking Avenge how he feels about today's games here. He is the MVP. He's happy he was able to get the triple kill.
He's 6-2 now.
6-2. Very, very good score to have. Nearly getting an all kill, you know, if he had just come out one earlier, maybe he could have gone for it.
He's definitely top three in the season now, I feel.
When he practiced for today's matches, he only practiced for sniping Leenok.
Exactly what we said earlier, being the sniper here.
After he beat Gumiho, he thought, you know, maybe he could get the triple kill.
So that's what's so cool if you have such a team, really preparing those snipers. You know that Leenok will come out at some point. Preparing a sniper is always great, and StarTail did that. They were rewarded for it, not only by defeating Leenok, but then taking additional two wins, Avenge playing great games here.
But he said Bomber really helps him a lot as a team captain when he practices.
Also something that we mentioned in the past, Bomber just being the backbone of the team. Sometimes he can't really deliver the wins, but he is one of the trains in the team with the players every single time.
He added there just at the end that sometimes his teammates like to send him replays, so he's very thankful for his teammates to, you know, always give him that data he can study.
StarTail is just a great team.
Yeah, so just a great atmosphere there that they've gone. Their team has gone through so many changes, but they always seem like they always seem the same.
The king of taunting.
Yep, just gonna get a word from Bomber himself here.
아니요, 사실 저는 시간이 없어서 이 경기는 준비를 못했는데.
He didn't have a lot of time to prepare.
했는데 솔직히 질 것 같았어요.
He didn't have a lot of time, obviously, because of Codas. He thought it'd be a fun match if he played against Leenok, and that's why he told Leenok to come out. He said he knew he was going to lose to the
Banelings. I mean,
he can't be happy either way. They won the match, so.
플레이오프 꼭 진출하도록 하겠습니다.
So 네,
that's actually
자,
a pretty cool what he said. Very honest. He says that Startel 네, is not doing as well as
자,
they thought they would in the team league. But he thanks the fans for supporting 그렇죠. them and promises that they will give their best for the rest of the season. That's very honest. That it, coming into the season, they struggled a little bit, but yeah. with wins against FXO and wins with, they were winning with a 4-1 here. That really helps them a lot.
In the time between last season of GSTL and this season, we had Heart of the Swarm come out. We had so yeah. many stars rise up for this team. Curious became kind of somewhat of a star. We had Life, who became the biggest star. Bomber came back into form. So going into the season, you know, right at the preseason, everyone was thinking Startale is the team to take it all. Then they had some struggles, and Bomber, you know, he clearly stated that we're not doing as well as we had thought, we're not doing as well as we had promised, but we're going to continue to go forward here, and today is a very important win for them.
I love what Avenged said. It's like, usually when you look at these teams, you always look at who delivers the best results, but Avenged stating how important Bomber is to the team, that is something that cannot be understated, I feel. You have to really point that out, how much he works for the team, with the team, and it shows. Even if he loses here to Leenok, he knows that with his help, other players can just pick it up.
Yeah, and, you know, StarCraft is a one-on-one sport, just like fencing, for example, or even like if you look at running, it's an individual sport. When you have a team that trains you and tells you what your weaknesses are and tells you how they can help you, that's how it really is a team sport. You know, Team League obviously is one team against another, but it's still one-on-ones. And Avenged is just pulling different elements of his team into every single game we're watching.
Yeah, I still remember when I was back then watching when Naniwa was still playing in the individual league and went to the Startale house, and Bomber played with everybody. He had his own games to prepare for, but he trained with everyone, playing different matchups and helping them so much the entire day. This guy is for good reason the captain of the team, and here you can really see that it pays off. They have five games now, 3-2, plus 5 as the indicator, so a really good position for them so far.
Puts them into the third place, so they're, you know, so far in that playoff zone. FX Open, on the other hand, is not falling down to 6th place, and their indicator goes down to 0 here.
Yeah, FXO is struggling a little bit at first in the season, and then they had a few very good matches, very strong matches, but now they have to be careful. Of course, they are still in a position where they can reach the playoffs, but they can't get complacent at this point.
Yeah, tomorrow's match is going to be 5 hours earlier than today. It's what people are calling the best versus the worst, as MVP being the frontliner and NSHost being all the way at the bottom.
Yeah. If MVP wins tomorrow's match, then they will claim the pole position once again, currently XM Asa being ranked 1.
Yeah, but of course, I feel like you said, just not playing all those matches just yet is part of the reason
exactly.
for that.
They have to play one additional match, and then we'll find out if they can once again claim the top spot in the rankings, or if they will then just... I think they're still second even if they lose, unless they're getting all killed, which I don't really see happening.
Yeah, actually, I think that's the only way, because I think it's plus 6 versus plus 2, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, would have to check that again. But NSHost has been struggling a bit this season, and tomorrow is going to be very important for them. But people are rightly so worried for them, and I feel that... I don't know what they can do. They have to find some
angle
against Team MVP, but MVP is looking so strong in the Team League, so we're going to find out tomorrow if they can perform the miracle, or if MVP will crush them, win the match, and then continue to be the top rank in the season. I really hope that you guys enjoyed today's matches. We'll be back tomorrow at 1:10 p.m. KST. See you guys then. Bye-bye. No longer blind. A minor setback, this post to be friend of mine. Emptied the clip on me one night when a friendly fight turned personal. Guess he wasn't my friend after all. After a brawl, hit me 3 times and I wouldn't fall. Made it through with a blessing. Karma with no confession. Believe in my body armor is made of fate from the heavens. Flip